Okay, welcome to the lecture series related to SCI and remaining topic of object-oriented programming. So today we will discuss this topic, object-oriented modeling of user interface design, and this is the last topic of our last unit. Okay, after that there is no any topic remains. Okay, all syllabus are covered. So let's start with our topic. So already we discussed in previous topic about previous lecture about interaction, interface object, interface actions. Okay, and here we study about methodology of OUID and object oriented modeling using UML. Use cases, analysis object, tasks, scenarios, dialogue, transition chart, dialogue component specifications, interface prototype, and task flow. And we will discuss about design model, view controller architecture, design classes MVC, and then at last an example edge case study. So we know about the object oriented programming. Now we will use that concept in our SCI. So presently user interface are built using rapid UI builders with extensive use of graphical elements libraries, and this ease in deploying an UI may lead to haphazard designs, and to design usable interfaces we need to specify interaction goals, and then formal specification of UI leads to robust and effective UI. And object oriented allows you reuse of existing and tested UI elements. An object-oriented specification of UI should be directed towards implementer and the user. Then end user relies on mental model to predict behavior of the systems. Okay, mental model is the internal representations of the structure and behavior of the system or reality. And then accurate mental model helps user to understand and operate system efficiently. And immediate and pervasive perceivable visual feedback of every interactions with interface helps an end users to tune his mental model. Okay, and the perceptions about his or her interactions can further reinforce mental models toward ideal state. Okay, and thus the visible user interface should reflect user's mental model. So user's mental model is important. And an object-oriented application is a collection of software objects representing the application domain. An object-oriented interface therefore connects user with the real world, manipulating software object of the background applications. Okay, so here you can see a diagram related to manipulation and mental models. Okay, so mental models of human, okay, user, and manipulations, user interface request, then applications response, and then user interface feedback. Okay, so interface design should strive to make use successfully accomplish their goals with the help of interaction task and manipulation of required interface elements. So there are already we know about goals, tasks, and interface elements. Okay, so interface objects. So at top level, one interface is a collection dialogues. Okay, and a dialogue is an aggregation of one or more components, and a component is further a collection of window elements that allow user to perform a meaningful actions. Okay, and component is implemented using class having with windowing elements or components. So there is the interface, dialogue, and component. Here you can see, okay, one to one relationships, here one to many relationships. Okay, so above figure shows a UML, here figure shows the UML representation of an object oriented interface, and filled diamond shows compositions while empty diamond shows aggregations, and one dot dot star represents one or many multiplicity of relationships. So there is a one to many relationships, okay, or one to one also. So again, interface actions. So user performs operations on interface to fulfill his goals by using system function. So an use case is a specific way of user using system's functionality. Okay, It shows the system's functionality. So use case specifies sequence of operations with the interface to be performed. And an operation is an activity for which the system is implemented, like place order, draw picture, etc. And the operation consists of one or more tasks like saving, drawing, deleting. And the action is the smallest activity user performs on the user interface, press button, drag picture, etc. So there is the operations, okay, one to many tasks relationship, then again one to many actions. It may be one to one or one to many. Then methodologies for object oriented UI design, here you can see the picture, okay, task analysis, then goes to objects, then goes to views, again goes to task, and there is the reply response, okay, and again interactions for task related, okay, then finally goes to object. So there are discovery phase, okay, this is the another methodology here, user class, user goals, task model, and user use cases, okay. So in first user class, identify the who are the real users, okay, then in user goals, what are the different goals of users, okay, then task model, how are these goals currently achieved, okay, and what at last use cases, what does the system need to support. So that's make UML. So again this describes more about UML, okay. So again, what is the user's mental model, okay. So simply metaphors, real world and software object representation in user object. Then again, what do users do, what does the system do, this is the task overview. Again, abstract view is what do users need to see to accomplish a task, visualization, graphic icons, etc. Then what are the exact user and system interactions for task flow, and then last, what happens to an object when user interact with it. So that's make use cases, okay. So again, there is the flow methodology. So use case model, okay, scenario, dialog flow model, object model, dialog style guide, dialog model, dialog template, and user interface prototype. And again, it goes to for evaluations user case model. So again, we can represent this using flow diagram. And object-oriented modeling of user interface. So first step is to analyze of user requirements, identifying use cases, design specifies the structure and component required each dialog to accomplish the use case. The interfaces are then developed iteratively and tested against with use case specifications and various criteria like performance, usability, etc. And here is the example like personal banking applications. So why would a user interact with such applications, why we need these applications, and what are his goals and use cases for personal banking applications. You can see here there is a user, then this application uses for check balance and check transactions and pay bill online. Again, object analysis model. So in here the sequence of operation documented for each use case are analyzed to identify key objects in the application domain and resulting into an object model, and key objects are called analysis objects, and the diagram showing relationship between these objects is called object diagram. So here is the link shows the relationship between each module, okay. So users, transactions, bank account, bill, creditor, payment, withdrawal, deposit. So this diagram shows the not complete but most of the operations related to banking, okay. Then task operation analysis. So the sequence of tasks, user interaction, and system feedbacks are specified for each use case, which is called scenario. And scenario specifies detailed interactions with interface elements and feedback received. Operations or scenario are analyzed to identify interaction tasks, okay. So here is the examples for banking related applications. So use case operations, check balance, select account, view balance. Scenario 2, use case operations, pay bill online, select account, update bill, put bill for payment. And in scenario 3, use case operations, check transactions, so select account, view transactions. So the task list as below: select account, view balance, view transaction, update bill, and put bill for payment. Then behavioral structure specifications, so dialogues, transitions. So state register diagram shows relationship between dialogues, okay, or simply windows of an interface, and every dialogue is considered as a state of the system. Then events, user actions that trigger transition from one dialogue to another are specified, and a do statement within dialogue specifies task number from scenario. Then conditions for transition from one dialogue to another are written in square brackets, and operation during transition are written after trigger a preceded with slash. So here you can see start, okay, it then bank terminal goes, okay, do 2, 4, 5, 6. Then it goes for account selection, okay, do 1. So select account, then close, okay, again it goes to 3. After 2, so simply transaction history, okay, so there is a condition account greater than 0, and in previous account greater than 1, so again close, then goes 4, 5, 6, and at last 7, bill selection. Okay, do 7, then you will select the bill and pay the bill. Bills greater than 0, then okay, okay, load bill again, and then after it's complete the transitions, okay. So again you can see the slash, okay, okay, and load bill, okay, so triggers are preceded with slash. So operation during transition are written here after trigger, okay. Then interface component specifications, so specify UI components required to carry out tasks with each dialog, types of UI component, input, output, okay. Then so below is dialog, bank terminal having instances of 3 components. Then bank terminal dialog, okay, balance, account number, label, balance label, then bill, creditor account, creditor name, due date, amount, then application control, QE transaction, select account, select bill. So structure elements, windows, menu icons, control tabs, interactions elements, cursor, pointer, selection handle. Then component increase reusability and consistency of UI, and a component can be created using element from scratch or from available standard dialog classes or component from library packages. Again you can see interface prototyping. So guidelines for prototyping, like follow style guidelines, guides, consider aesthetics and usability, already we studied user standard GUI builders, then validate with end users. So here you can see a bank terminal applications window, okay, so application controls on top, then balance, you can see balance after giving account number, okay, then bill. So it gives the creditor account, creditor name, due date and amount, okay, then save. So thorough designing of dialogues and component leads to identifications of highly reusable interface elements, which finally leads to harmonized user interface, okay. Then task specifications and flow. So specify sequence of actions to be performed on final user interface for a task. And tasks are selected from use case scenarios, okay, and designers perform a walkthrough with final interface for each task, and specification of event trace of interactions among user interface and system can also be depicted with interaction diagram as below. So here you can see interaction diagram, okay, selecting an account, banking account. So there is a BT bank terminal dialog, and there is a AS account selection dialog. So there is a user, BT balance, BT application control, AS account selection, AS tax list, AS dialog control, and at last system. So this shows the complete events, okay, specification of events of each object in banking applications, okay. And object shown as rectangles at top, and object interaction shows by arrows and messages. And tails of the arrows shows the invoking objects, and time axis runs from top to bottom. Okay, so we go to next. converting UI specification into language specification design. So each application consists of three types of objects. Domain of model objects represent the real world, and model objects are controlled by controller objects, and these controller are unaware of view objects. Okay, and view objects are on boundary of system interacting with end users. So view objects only knows how to present feedback and accept user inputs. They do not take decisions or process information. And the controller object receives the request from view objects, which makes application specific decisions through model objects, and this is called MVC. Okay, architecture. So here you can see the diagram. So there is a user, okay, there is the manipulations, view objects for user interface, controller objects for business logics, and model objects for domain specific entities. And again, these manipulation interpreted actions and action requests. After performing these operations, the domain specific entities gives results, okay, then business logics provide action requests, and at last the user gets the feedback. Then converting UI specification into language specification design using this earlier model. So event dialog is analyzes in analysis model forms view object in design model, okay, like balance, bill, application control, and dialog component becomes object member of respective view object, and there is a single controller object for every view object, okay, and single controller may be related to more than one model object and vice versa. Again, manipulations and feedback get behavior of component is implemented as member functions of the view component class, and query methods are designed for controller objects. Okay, so here you can see more. Okay, sorry, here. Okay, and then application specific logic is implemented in controller classes, and model classes have domain specific knowledge. Event traces and state machines in analyzing sense are used to find member function of designed classes. Then design model in next slide depicts the all classes of application. So here is the complete design model. Okay, all classes in design model. So this is the banking related applications. Okay, account selection controller, account model, bank terminal controller, account selection view, bank terminal view, and their balance view component, application control view components, and text list view component, and dialog control view components. So there are methods, and there are the you can say simply data. Okay, so there are attributes, okay, and then methods applied for performing those operations on data, okay, using objects and classes. So I will not discuss all these operations here. Okay, simply you can understand about the complete operation about banking here using this design model. Then here is the example of modeling UI for an internet book shopping interface are shown. Okay, so simply UI model case study, like first step is describing use cases. Okay, then step two, describing activity diagrams. Then step three, generating class diagrams. Then step four, generating GUI components. So we have a topic, internet book shopping, okay, IBS in short. So in the IBS, there basically appear three actors: the customer, the ordering manager, and the administrator. So a customer directly carries out the purchases by the internet and querying certain issues of the product in a catalog of books before carrying out the purchase, and the manager deals with total or partially customer's order, and finally the system's administrators can manage the catalog of book, adding and eliminating books in the catalog or simply modifying those already existing. Use case diagram follows in the next slide. So you can see here, this is the use case diagram for IBS. Okay, IBS na? Okay, IBS. So we will not discuss all these things here. You can go and check about this example. Okay, it is easy. And you have to make this use cases and practice to make use cases with different you can say applications for like banking and this library related. Then again, UI model state charts for this library. Okay, so first A is the purchase activity diagram. Then B shows the manage shopping cart activity diagram. Then C shows the query catalog activity diagram, and the D shows the shopping cart activity diagram, and the last one is the purchase information activity diagram. So these all state charts are for different operations. Then again, design model and design classes. So you can see complete model or design classes of this book IBS. Okay. IBS system. So there are different you can say methods or classes, like here J applets, okay, query catalog, shopping cart, okay, customer purchase, JBL, okay. So these are all linked with each other, okay, one to one or one to many. Then user interface implementation. So you can see some menus here. So first represent query catalog applets use case, okay. And shopping cart applets use case here. Then B purchase applet use case, okay, and then information applet use cases. So these are the references for more study about this object oriented programming paradigm, okay, and the object designing object oriented user interfaces. Okay, so here we complete our SCI related all topics. Okay, the class is over here. Thank you.